Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning Channel. In Flame 2017 Extension 1, there have been tons of updates to object selection, as well as object display in action. When combining all of these updates together, the general usability should allow you to work more comfortably in the Action 3D environment. The updated functionalities are not footage specific, so you can use any media to follow along. Just ensure you have an Action 3D composite with some images, lighting, and 3D geometry. Now I have set up Action with a 2-up view. This lets you see the connection between the nodes in the Action schematic and the objects in the live preview result viewer. Now a concerted effort has been made to streamline selection principles across the Flame products. In other words, the way you select things, add more or remove objects should be consistent throughout the application. For example, you can click any object to select it. To add to the selection, you hold Ctrl and click on other objects. This can be in the schematic or in the result viewer. To remove objects from the selection, you hold Ctrl again and click objects to deselect them. If you tried this in batch, the behavior should be the same unlike previous versions of Flame. You should also notice that the object selection colors in the view now match the selection colors applied to the nodes. So in terms of the selection priority, you can now determine that in either view. We'll come back to multi-selections later on, as there is a new behavior which is very handy, but I'd like to focus on how you can pick objects. In previous versions of the Flame products, when you wanted to gesturally pick something in the view, you would have to click on the border or edge of the object. This is available, but not necessary in every case. Now you can click anywhere over an object to select it. This includes surfaces and geometries. But one area, believe it or not, which would be slightly tricky, is when surfaces overlap in 3D space. So the common behavior is to always select the surface closest to the camera. Even if you can see the object through an alpha of the foreground surface, you will not be able to select it. So you have a few options to select the other surfaces. You could orbit the camera until you have a clear view of the surface you're selecting, but this will disrupt any camera positioning you may be using. So an alternative is to click the outline of the surface. When you click the outline, it ignores the 3D space and selects the surface. The final option for making a selection with overlapping objects is called depth picking. So if you have lots of objects overlapping each other in 3D space, you hold Shift and click on the front object. This will select all the overlapping objects regardless of their position in 3D space. Next, you would press Q to cycle between the selected objects to get to the particular one you want to adjust. Please note that by pressing Shift Q cycles the selection in the opposite direction. Now I'd like to remind you that you can cycle the wireframe icons between icons off, selected, and icons on using the I keyboard shortcut. To ensure you know what icons you're seeing, there is a new toggle button for the wireframe icons in the viewport menu bar. So you can tell what icons you're looking at, and you don't need to go to the node preferences to confirm the icons display. There is also a new group off option that we'll discuss in another video on working with groups in action. So with the improvements in which you can select objects in the view, it's easy to select objects even when viewing with selected mode. You can just tap an object to select it. Now I'll select this geometry in the composite, and you can see the new way in which you can view a geometry selection. Previously, when you selected a 3D object in action, you would get a chunky bounding box around the object, making it difficult to really see where the object started and where it finished. In Flame 2017 Extension 1, you now get a proper outline around the geometry, making it easier to identify. This is the default viewing icon, but you can change the viewing mode by pressing Space I. The second mode you have is the wireframe display. You would normally see this representation in other 3D applications. It's great for examining 3D objects and seeing the faces of the geometry. If you press Space I again, this will cycle to the old bounding box selection. The keyboard shortcut will cycle the icon viewing modes, but it is also available as a drop-down menu in the Action Preferences under Display and Icons. Now there are a few extra functions that will definitely come in handy when it comes to selections. The first one, which is not so obvious, is the Lock Selection function. So let's say that you select some objects in the schematic or the result view. If you press Space Alt L, this will lock your selection. Regardless where you click, the selection will never be deselected. Press Space Alt L to unlock the selection as well. Now you can use this in tandem with the next function known as Solo Mode. This has been around for a while, but it has received a few updates in this version. Select any object or objects and press the Solo button to the right of the interface. Whatever is selected will appear in the solo view. If you click between different objects, the solo view will dynamically switch. Just remember that if you are soloing a large flow graph, ensure that you select the topmost node to display everything properly in the selection. But if you have nothing selected in the composite, the solo view will be empty. So I'm sure that you've already worked out that if you locked the selection to some objects, you won't accidentally keep deselecting them while working in the solo view. Disable the solo view if it's still on. Finally, let's come back to multi-selections once more. Create a selection over a bunch of axis nodes using Control. Firstly, if you haven't already seen this in another video, when you select nodes in action and they're not connected to the same flow graph, you can move them as a selection. This now matches the behavior with nodes in batch. You can also frame selected nodes by pressing Space F in the schematic. So if you're working in a complex schematic with lots of nodes, you could select the objects in the result view and frame the nodes in the schematic. Or you could do it the other way around. Select the nodes in the schematic and frame them in the result viewer. The whole point is that you can make a multiple selection and frame it into any view. Now, an old behavior that occurred with multi-selecting nodes was that you would get a global tab in the controls, allowing you to make relative transformations to the selection. This is still available, but it is cycled with a new mode for multi-selection. If you press Space M, you will find the multi-axis transformation that you would have been used to. So this will allow for relative positioning of the multi-selected objects. But if you press Space M again, you can now do individual axis adjustment within the selection. So the multi-axis tab disappears, and you see the tab for one of the selected nodes in the multi-selection. If you press Q, you can cycle through all the individual nodes in the multi-selection. Shift-Q will perform the inverse cycle. The idea behind these multi-selection modes is that it should reduce the number of clicking in the action schematic when you are flipping between individual nodes and a multi-selection of nodes. So we've covered loads of improvements with selecting objects and displaying the selections in action. Don't forget, there are quite a few other improvements in action that are covered in other videos. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.